February 17, 1753. We welcome to James Grammy. A last Grammy for the voice in such ballroom for Nautilus films. And it has very impressionate effects. As it turns out, spent with the set of the game James Green to Congo. But it was not easy. James looked at the note with crazed face and said,
"You'll never find me, Emma."
The force of this event on this Grammy are only four days blur that no master can choose. Even one was only fair. Ed scrawled forward and stood near the no-derailed fed locomotive. Hey, that way, that was. Those were genius. The being general looked at us and didn't know what was going or what happened at not what that engine that was standing off the lamp was on number 5. We explained it what happened over the last 4 days and James managed to understand what was going on. I was very sorry for what I had done to Harvey. The being engine basically cracked at the top of what I had done. And slowly, as I'm perturbed, put James back on the track. Now, we had a lot of plan, although James mentioned it less than a minute was passing by with express when the guys went to Lego Arcini. Judging the later than is for now, most of us assumed something it was controlling James, making a totally different journey. So that's cool, I guess, life to more, Lukoil. We also, while we were working, got contacted by Skyway, who told us that they had detected Peter Sen, or looked at the telechip and said something about Cyrandale. We think he was on the Delta Focus Ridge. We've reunited with Gordon, Perk and Carriage Chad and I catching over here. Miguel and Yemini said a little.
Yesterday, if we were in some troubles, James would all watch on our way.
But today, I said to leave us.
12:13. We left the cargo shed, mostly feeling good. Harvey's death still lingers in our minds. Gordon is still furious with James for what happened. James is still terribly sorry. Hi still has Harvey's blood on his side and Percy. In fact, he seems really excited about the whole thing. That's weird. The entire trip was silent, except for James and Hi's exchanging a few words every now and then. Finally, we snuck into Wellsworth to see a whole team waiting for us. Behind Toby were Edward Oliver, Rosie and Derek, who was in the same state as Gordon. Along with Toad Sarah and Nicole, but come on. But, most importantly, he was by Edward's side. He was a smart gentleman. The one who is the shining light of hope for many in this dark time. Sir Bertram Topham Hatt. After meeting the group, we finally got everyone's stories. This will be a long story, so be patient. Gordon was resting after taking a freight train to the big station. He could only scream as he felt his right side twist and twitch, trapped in writhing agony. Not long after, Harvey arrived. Gordon broke down, saying that Harvey was the only thing keeping him alive, and James had just killed him. So Edward went. So we decided to start Operation Brendan Storm. James goes in front with Gordon's snow machine. Heis goes in the back with two wagons and one open wagon. And if something goes wrong, Toby will be in the back to escape. They're ready to go. God only knows what happened to everyone in Edward's line. The time is running out, and we have sisters to save.